Let me guess. You never know what article you need to use. Is it uno cappuccino or un cappuccino? Let's find out. Hi there and welcome to my channel. I am Carlo and this is my class for beginners. In this video we are going to see indefinite articles, articoli indefiniti. Are you ready? Let's get started. When you don't know what article you need, you have to see what is the word you are using. Una is followed by a feminine word starting with a consonant. For instance, una pizza, una ragazza, una Macedonia. When do we need to use un apostrophe? Un apostrophe is when the feminine word starts with a vowel. For instance, aranciata, un'aranciata. So you only hear one A. That's why we cut the first one and we have un apostrophe, aranciata. So this is the basic rule. Un apostrophe is followed by a feminine word starting with a vowel. What about masculine? Un panino, un cornetto. So we have un followed by a masculine word beginning with both a consonant or a vowel. It doesn't really matter. So why do we have uno? What's that for? Uno is followed by a masculine word starting with S plus consonant. For instance, spumante, studente, or a masculine word starting with Y, like yogurt, or a masculine word starting with a Z, like zaino, or a masculine word starting with PS, like psicologo. Una, un, uno stand for the English a, an. It goes without saying that we use these articles with singular nouns. That's not the plural. That's it for today. I hope you like the video. Please share it, like it, leave a comment and let me know your opinion on my videos. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it yet, and see you next time!